Hello and welcome from the Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety Administration, or PHMSA. PHMSA is the federal agency that protects the public from risks in the transportation of hazardous materials by pipeline and other modes of transportation. The National Pipeline Mapping System is a program that uses GIS technology to map and analyze the pipelines that PHMSA regulates. I will review how to use the National Pipeline Mapping System's Public Viewer application. The Public Viewer grants you access to view hazardous liquid and gas transmission pipelines in a county that you select. The Public Viewer is open to anyone and is the subject of this tutorial. Another application called PIMA also exists. PIMA is accessible only to government officials and to pipeline operators. If you fit into one of those categories, you can apply for a PIMA username and password on the home page of the NPMS website. The NPMS Public Viewer allows you to view pipeline maps in a county that you select. You can view pipelines on a street map or aerial photograph background. You can click on those pipelines with the Identify tool to find which company operates the pipelines, learn what commodity they carry, and how to contact that pipeline operator. You can also produce a PDF map of those pipelines. Please read the disclaimer and note that NPMS data is not a substitute for calling 811 before you begin a project that involves digging. Also note that the extent to which you can zoom in on the Public Viewer is limited in accordance with PHMSA's security policy. We will now enter the Public Viewer. Take a look at the green box on the login page. This notice explains whether you will need to click the Compatibility View button in order to enter the Public Viewer. We are using Internet Explorer 8. So the Compatibility View button should be clicked, and we see that it is. The county we will view is Harris County, Texas, so we'll pick this state and county from the drop-down list. The Public Viewer has launched, but we cannot see the map window. This is because we do not have the browser window maximized. Now we see the pipelines in Harris County, Texas. Let's go through the major elements of the Public Viewer. The map window is in the center. The layer list is on the left. You can turn layers on or off by clicking in the box next to them. The spinning icon at the top right corner of the map window means that the application is processing our command. If you wanted to view liquefied natural gas plants or breakout tanks, you could also click to turn them on. Likewise, we can change the background from a street map to an aerial map by clicking next to the word aerial. Also note that the contact for support for the Public Viewer is at the bottom left of the layer list. Finally, the toolbar is at the top of the screen. It contains the tools we'll use to zoom in and out, find out more information about a pipeline, and produce a PDF of our pipeline map. The box titled View Pipelines By contains several options for zooming the map to an area or to a specific operator's pipelines. We'll take a closer look at the pipelines by zooming into a street address. We're entering the address of a library in Houston. You must have all components of the address, including the zip code. Now the map has zoomed to our address, which is indicated by a star. We would like to see who operates the pipelines near the library and how close they are to the library. Note that we will be unable to zoom in closer because of the security restrictions on the Public Viewer. If we try to zoom in closer, the pipelines on the map will disappear. First, let's see who operates the pipeline that is closest to the library. Use the Identify tool to get that information. This screen shows all possible results in the area I clicked on. Because the pipeline is red, it is a liquid pipeline, so I will click on the Hazardous Liquid Pipelines tab. Notice that the pipeline is operated by Buckeye Gulf Coast and that it carries liquefied petroleum gas. We can also see the contact information for that pipeline. Note that the status code says in service. If the pipeline is idle, retired, or abandoned, that information will appear in the status code box. We can repeat the identify operation for any other pipelines or other features on the map. Next, we'll measure how close the library is to the nearest gas pipeline. Let's turn off the liquid pipeline so that we can see the gas transmission lines more easily. Note that only transmission lines are shown. Gas distribution pipelines and gas gathering pipelines are not part of the NPMS. We'll use the measure tool to measure that distance. We click on the tool and drag a line from the star to the gas pipeline. We see that the distance is approximately 0.2 miles. Other tools on the toolbar include tools to see the maps for Alaska, Hawaii, and Puerto Rico, as well as the zoom in and zoom out tools, a pan tool to move the map, a tool to select pipelines by dragging a box, to clear a selection, to derive a latitude-longitude point, and to print our map. To zoom in, click on the Zoom In tool and drag a box around the area you wish to zoom to. If the pipelines disappear, you have zoomed in too far. Use the Zoom Out tool to draw a box. The larger the box, the less the map will zoom out. The pipelines reappear once we have zoomed out past the zoom limit. The Pan button allows us to drag the map in any direction. Finally, we will make a PDF of our pipeline map. Simply click on the Print button. We can choose the size of the map. We'll choose 8.5 by 11. This concludes our introduction to the NPMS Public Viewer. Please review the help manual if you have any questions or contact NPMS staff. Thank you.